Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Glad to meet you again. I would like to present to you our report about integrative characteristics of Veturonian Candiacian boundary in the northwestern Caucasus. The purpose of this work is to determine characteristics of the Veturonian-Candiacian boundary in the northwestern Caucasus. This section is located in the northwestern part of North or Greater Caucasus and belongs to the Novorossiysko-Lazarevskaya tectonic zone. Number one, red circle is studied section. This section is located in the Abin River Valley and belongs to the folded Alakhtonos-Anapa-Agoy subzone of Novorossiysko-Lazarevskaya tectonic zone of the Greater Caucasus. The rocks are exposed within Shapsuk Quarry. The subject of study was the sediments of Natukhai formation in the section of the northwestern wall of the worked-out quarry north of the Shapsukskaya village. The purpose of this work is to determine characteristics of the section of the Veturonian-Candiacian boundary in the northwestern Caucasus on the basis of litho, bio, and hemostratigraphic study. The section of the Shapsuk quarry is represented by rhythmic, substantially carbonate sequence, which is the monocline steeply dipping to the south. The exposed part of the section has a thickness about 80 meters. 22 samples were studied by a different methods. Hemipelagic sediments, mainly micritic thin and thick-bedded limestone, clay limestones, calcareous clays, rarely thin beds of sandstone and siltstones presented here. Four main types of microfacies have been identified, differing from each other in composition, color, structure, texture, paleontological characteristics. Thin layers of red limestone are marked in the Shapsuk section. A similar feature for the Upper Turonian-Santonian interval was noted in Dagestan area by Rengarten. And later, the red limestones were described in the same interval on very wide space. See a series of publications Mikhail Vagreich, Svisko, Otos. Note the similarity in the rhythmic structure of the two sections. The first, A, is GSSP section Zalgitzer-Zalder, and B is our section of quarry. The sedimentological features of these rocks were studied in thin sections also, and we have A, foraminiferal limestone, mudstone. B, speculite foraminiferal limestone, wag, mudstone. C, pitonella foraminiferal limestone, wag, peckstone. And D, small to fine-grained sandstone. First conclusion. Sedimentation took place in a relatively deep open sea basin. Sandy and silty layers record short-term moments of coastline retreat towards the basin and increase in the intensity of removal from the supply province. Now about biostratigraphic results. The zonal stratigraphy of Veturonian-Candiacian is based mainly on the stratigraphic distribution of phanerozoites and ammonites. Remains of macrofauna were not found in the section of Shapsuk quarry. In order to refine the age of deposits, the identification of foraminifera was carried out, among which planktic formas were predominate. The basis for determining the age of rocks is the zonal scheme for Crimea-Caucasian area and its comparison with the schemes of our authors, publication in Kopayevich Alexeyev. Planktic Forum the Nation. The lower part of Shapsug quarry section, samples number 1 to 5, is characterized the high diversity of species of Margina truncana, as well as the absence of Helvetia glabrotana helvetica. This indicates what the section included. The interval between 1 to 5 belongs to the Margina truncana pseudolineana zone, what is to the middle part of the Turonian. Higher, a sharp increase in the taxonomic diversity Margina truncana, or so-called large Margina truncanids, to the upper Turonian, the sections of central Poland, in the upper Turonian, lower Kanyatsian, in the sections of southwestern Crimea and northeastern Caucasus. And higher, Dicarinella concavata zone indicates the presence of the lower Kanyatsian in the section. What is the upper part of the Margina truncana coronata zone of the Crimea-Caucasian zonal scale? At the same time, the presence of morphotype with a strongly convex umbilical side in sample 18th and above allows us to compare with part of the section with the Kanyatsian of the Dicarinella concavata zone of the Mediterranean planktic scale. Benthic forums subdivision. Gavalinella maniliformis indicates what the age of deposits is not older than the Middle Turonian, and the appearance of the first protostanciaina species in sample 7, the late Turonian age. In the upper part of the section, a zonal index Reusella kelleri appears in sample 16th. And protostanciaina granulata in sample 18th confirms the early Kanyatsian age. The benthic foraminifer associations shows great similarity with the Eastern European platform, but more uniform. The convenience of these schemes lies in the constant presence in the ceramid data. It is very useful for stratigraphy data. Second conclusion, foraminiferal assemblages are similar to the association of the settled parts of the Tethys area, but they are less diverse. Throughout the entire Turonian-Kanyatsian interval, the territory was a relatively deep open shear basin. The next three slides are plates with foraminifera for our section. For compare, we give the plates, planktonic and benthic forums from GSSP and Auxiliaria section. In this plate, you can see the Dicarinella with very interesting morphology, with Dicarinella concavata, Dicarinella primitiva, and this taxa is very rare in our section. Second conclusion, foraminiferal assemblage show close to the association of central part of Tethys area, but they are less diverse. The best planktic forum Turonian-Kanyatsian boundary marker is Dicarinella concavata. However, in the Shapsug section, this species is represented by single specimens and appears only in the upper part of a section. This event does not recognized and in Salzgitter-Zalder section, only in auxiliary section. Now, data about isotope analysis. Isotope stratigraphy based on the curve of the 13th carbon changes throughout the late Cretaceous is well developed. The 13 carbon isotope curve of the Cretaceous deposits of Shapsug quarry is significantly similar to the change in this data in GSSP section. The excursion of these values are good markers what can be traced over significant distances, which allows reliable stratigraphic correlation. You can see 1, 2, 3 boundary and isotope stratigraphy marker. This slide demonstrate the isotope analysis in publication Valashek Alter and our section. Third conclusion. Thus, based on the analysis of changes in the isotopic composition, 13th carbon, and the fluctuation of the isotopic curve, it was possible to detail the stratigraphic subdivision of the Turonian-Konyatsyan of the section and the position of boundary of the Turonian and Konyatsyan also. The section of Shapsug quarry showed a great similarity with GSSP section, and it was clear they are in the same paleogeographic area. Based on the continuity of a section, its accessibility, similarity of lithology and composition of microfossils with GSSP section, it can be proposed as a possible hippostratotype on the lower boundary of the Konyatsyan for the territory of Crimea-Caucasus area. It is also important what the location of the section is convenient for access to it, where are well developed and for infrastructure nearby. The decision to this issue seems to be very actual for regional Upper Cretaceous stratigraphy. However, before starting this procedure, remains of ceramids and ammonites must be found in this section. Without this, such an offer is not valid. This is quite possible when it is studied in detail for this purpose. Now we have the first results. This is first in the ceramids. Thank you very much for your attention.